Greece is one of the biblical countries. There are lots of archaeological sites which are also biblical sites, and it's a great combination of history, archaeology and Bible. So many Christians who visit the country can visit these places, and really the Bible can be more alive in these sites.
And tell us a bit about how you show the connection, the real solid connections between something like St. Paul's visit and this place.
You know, Apostle Paul visited Greece during his second missionary journey, and cities like Philippi, Thessalonica, Berea, Athens and Corinth are the main biblical sites. For example, we are in Corinth right now. Behind me is the Temple of Apollo, and Apostle Paul stayed in Corinth for 1.5 years, 18 months. He started the church here. He was brought in front of Gallio, and actually one of the highlights of this place here is the Bima of Gallio. The Bima, which was the speaker's platform and became the judgment seat for Apostle Paul. And we actually see that. It's not a tradition, but it's the authentic place.
And can you tell us about something that has some evidence that what's written in the New Testament actually happened?
One inscription which was found near the theater in Corinth bears the name of Erastus. We know that Erastus was the city treasurer, the minister of finances, and his name is mentioned in the scriptures. And this is a very important inscription which shows the authenticity of the scriptures, and it shows also that in the early church of Corinth, the congregation didn't consist only of low-class citizens, but members of the government were members of the church. And Erastus was the edile. The Latin term edile is the equivalent to the Greek word oikonomos. So he took care of the city, public constructions, as well as the finances. So it's one of the many inscriptions which were found, which prove the authenticity of the scriptures.